Welcome, racers. So, welcome back to Assetto Corsa. And not competizione, not yet, just the old one, Road to Platinum. So, my road to the Platinum Trophy on PlayStation. I'm not sure what I want to do today. Either career, which there's still plenty to do. I could do, which series I have to do? I would have to do Intermediate Series 2 in this nice Mercedes-Benz. Probably all of them would be that car. And there is five of them. Or I could do some special events today. I think I would like to do something in Mazda, if there is something in Mazda MX-5. And the reason for that is, I have a race on Monday in that car. So sticking to that car and doing some more practice in it, even if on a different racetrack, would probably be beneficial. Just by getting used to that car, let's try to find anything with Mazda MX-5 Cup car. we have some monsters here, Lamborghini, well, a mix of different cars here. More Lambos, Mercedes. No Mazda so far. No Mazda. Here we go. Not necessarily a cup car, but a Mazda on a track which I kind of know, but don't remember. Controller, it's so easy, it's so much easier. Yeah, I would rather do the cup car. I wish there was some kind of search, like on the PC. PC is so much more user-friendly, the whole menu of Assetto Corsa in comparison to what they gave us on PlayStation. So that's the old MX-5. Or Miata, a Nürburgring. It's not that I don't like the racetrack, but I did so many things on it already, both online and offline. I mean, single player, that I don't want to go back to it. Mazda MX-5 NO. And the old Miata, and here we go, Mazda MX-5 Cup car, Barcelona, quick race. So there we have something here. What else do we have related to that car? I'm really surprised there's just one thing so far. Seems to be such a popular car. Quite a cool one as well. Okay, so either I missed it and there is more of MX-5 Cup car, or there's simply just a single event. We'll try it. It's a quick race, so to get the highest trophy, it has to be done on alien difficulty. And I'm not sure. Should I start on something? I should start on medium probably, just to get number of opponents. I cannot change anything but difficulty, right? Yeah, I'll try the medium first, just to get the feel of the car and the racetrack, and then I will gradually increase it. If I'm good enough, of course. I'll be trying to drive on the sequential, because that's what the Mazda has in real life. The MX-5 car has a sequential gearbox. And let's see how it goes. If it goes at all. I will try to load a setup from one of the other racetrack. I drove that car a few racetracks, Black Cat County. It's always an issue in that game if you try to load a setup from a truck you are not racing on actually at the moment. So let's just try that load. Lovely, that worked. Back to the controller, so much easier. I don't know how many laps I have to do it in this racetrack, but I shouldn't need 45 liters of fuel. The 20. I actually prefer that car with a bit more fuel than less, even on during the qualification. Okay, so we're trying for bronze. Okay, alien difficulty, so I will try with alien straight away. Okay, let's see. Oh, okay, don't drive on that. Avoid curbs. Let's try again. I was curb again. I still haven't learned anything, right? I got scared because I drove on the curb and I know what they can do. Thank you. beautifully. Fifth. I need to repeat myself, avoid curbs, avoid curbs. Close enough to get some slipstream out of the car in front. 209.573. Lap 3 out of 20. I wish I had a virtual mirror in the car. Lower than the previous one. time I was able to drive here without lifting. Well, the first time I tried, not I was able. Avoid those curves, that's what I have to remember about it. I lost quite a lot in this lap, 2.11, and my fastest is 2.09.2, almost 2 seconds. Quite a bad situation at the moment because I don't think I've got a slipstream for those in front of me. At the same time, I think the guy who's behind has my slipstream. Luckily, I pulled quite a good delta here. Yeah, I think he has to now worry about his position. Trying to have a mine. personal best. I may be close enough on the next lap to get the slipstream. If I keep it cold on this lap. Yes, I think I have a slipstream now. I'm close enough, which is good. I think I will start using second gear in the left hand. Right-hander there, I went a bit too wide. Nothing that I couldn't correct. Quite wide here, but I have the inside. That's a good exit. Still there on the left hand side. Yeah, he couldn't keep it. He was breaking late. there. Top racing here. Let's see how it's going to look like here. I was just late enough breaking to this chicane. And I think we secured the third position. Lap 9. Not my best exit out of this chicane. But that's okay. We still have 11th lap to secure two more positions. Reaching top speed of around 193-194 km per hour at that start-finish straight or main straight. So they brake here in the middle of the corner, something I don't like to do. I don't have to go full throttle, but at least I don't want to use brake in the corner, not in this one actually. A diabolical curve. So now I know that I put way too much fuel. It will be half of the race now. And I have quite a lot of fuel still left. Way too much. If I put half of that, it should still be enough, and I would have much lighter car. But I had no idea how much fuel the car needs for the 20 laps. He was defending it here quite nicely. But I will take the inside. Luckily for me, they cannot defend on that corner. But they're still quite fast in this minute. Okay, here we go. Probably, if I wouldn't move to left, he would buff into me. Safely say that the second position is secured now, as long as I don't do any mistakes. So let's try to avoid those curves, because they are the main reason for my mistakes. more or less halfway through that race. I'm just going to remind that this is my road to platinum, so a road to a podium trophy. This is one of the special events. It's a quick race in Mazda MX-5 at Barcelona circuit. To get the goal, it's necessary to win with AI at the highest alien difficulty, and this is what I am attempting here. I had a few failed attempts, but those fails happened quite early to the race, usually on the first or second lap, so I haven't wasted too much time there. I think I restarted three times quite early into the race, so this one's actually looking quite good. I'm now at the second place following first one. First place, still having around 8 laps to go. All goes well, should be able to catch him soon. As long as I avoid those curbs, that's the only thing I have to remember about. The outside one are fine, the inside one are what was causing the troubles. Here we go, that's what I'm saying. I drove on the curb and the car went sliding straight away. Okay, we have quite a good advantage over third, so we don't have any pressure coming from behind. Only pressure is in catching the first place and trying to overtake him. I'm driving with the sequential gearbox because that's what that Mazda has in real life, a sequential gearbox, special shifter. Oh, that was a nice entry and exit. I gained quite a lot in one single corner. Much lighter than it used to be. We burned through quite a lot of fuel. We still have plenty, way too much. Is it going to be a successful attack? I think it may be. It is. upstream. I'm still gaining some time just because the car became much lighter due to carrying less fuel at the moment. Micro slides there, just to keep it the direction I want to drive in. Okay, I got a little bit of a briefing room. Out of the slipstream now. Left curve there. Something I'm not comfortable doing, but unfortunately it happened. And I feel straight away that the car started sliding a little bit there, and luckily I caught it just in time. Right here. I don't think going upshifting to third so early is beneficial, but just less risky. And this is the first, my first lap below 2 minutes 9 seconds. I'm not sure if this is the fastest lap. It is fastest lap. Lovely. So we have five more laps to go. This is lap 16 of 20. laps. Quite a lot there, and that's okay. .208.491, a new PB, and a new fastest lap of the race. 90.94. Three laps to go. I clipped that left curve there, I had to lift a little bit, and even though I still got some time, so it was really good entry to the corner and then the exit. Mistake, I used the puddle. I shouldn't have to. I should have used the sequential. Two laps to go. half a second at a time as a nice delta. That was so stupid. See, that's what happens when you start chasing times rather than just finish the race. But at least it's not boring anymore. It was a bit boring for the last two laps. It's a final lap and I have to defend. It's right behind me. I need to cut him off of the slipstream. It's going to be interesting. So close. Let's race. 10 seconds was harsh there. I haven't made the same stupid mistake this time. And it's a win. Lovely. That was Mazda MX-5 Cup at Barcelona, a quick race on alien difficulty, and it's a win. Not a clean one. I made one mistake which could have costed me that win, but luckily I defended that first position and delivered. I have achieved tier 4, which is the alien, which is gold, which is exactly what I wanted. It was long enough, I think. I also had the fastest lap of the race. I can happily exit that race. I won't be doing anything else today, but I wanted to say thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the race, and I'll see you next time, probably in Assetto Corsa. If not tomorrow, then definitely on Monday, because there is a league online race which I'll be taking. So, thanks again for watching. Have a good night, and I'll see you next time.